In this video, I want to show you how to install sensenet 7 on your local computer. We will be using Visual Studio, command line and the browser. Before we start, please check if you have Visual Studio installed on your computer and you have a local SQL Server instance. First, create a new MVC project in Visual Studio. Click File, New Project, then choose ASP.NET Web Application. Name your new project. Select the destination and the solution name. Make sure the Create Directory for Solution option is checked. Right now, we don't want to connect this project to GitHub, TFS or any source control system. If you want to, turn on this feature. Click OK. Select MVC from ASP.NET templates. Click OK. When your project is created, the next step is to install sensenet 7 in this new project. For this, go to the Package Manager. Click Project. Select Manage NuGet Packages option from the drop-down menu. Switch to the Browse tab. For the package source, make sure the public NuGet.org source is selected. Search for the package with sensenet keyword. Look for sensenet services install package. Click Install. Most sensenet packages have two versions. The normal package, like sensenet services, includes only DLL files that can be used in any project, while the install packages include all necessary files for a new project. When installing, this will add all dependencies as well. In the Preview Changes window, you can see all the dependencies required for the sensenet services install package. Click OK. Some packages may have acceptance window. Click I accept to continue the installation process. As NuGet is not made for a whole CMS installation, modification of some files after the installation is required. For now, we consider this the best way to install SN7. When the process is completed, you can see a README file containing all the instructions to finalize the process. If you accidentally closed this file, you can find the same instructions on a community site or the GitHub page of the project. First, you need to modify the global ASX file. It's important to modify the ASX file, not the ASX.cs file. Right-click on the global ASX file and select View Markup option. Modify the inheritance following the README file. After that, you need to modify the global ASX.cs file. There are two things to modify here. The application class should inherit from sensenet services, sensenet global. Then change the application start method header and call the base method before all generated and custom method calls. It's important not to override the whole method, just the header, and add the base method call. Now, you can build your solution. Click Build, then choose Build Solution option. You can start the installation process of the sensenet content repository database. Please make sure that you have access to the SQL database server before the installation. Under the newly created web application, open Admin folder. Then right-click on Bin folder. Click Open Folder in File Explorer. Copy the path from the File Explorer. Open Command Prompt, type CD, then paste the path and hit Return. Run the installer with the command found in the README file. If your SQL Server has a different name, modify the data source before running the command. hit return and wait for the installation. After the process is complete, you have the SenseNet services package installed in your new project, without any graphical user interface. You can start working with this solution, or you can install additional packages as well. Keep in mind that with SN7, it is recommended to develop with even MVC or full JS. So feel free to use Aurelia, React, or other JS frameworks in your projects. For more information, please visit our community site, link in the description. Thanks for watching.